In logic, there's a close relationship between deductive and valid arguments, and there's a similar relationship between inductive and strong arguments. In standard logic, the term inductive argument basically means an argument that is intended to be strong rather than valid. So when you give an inductive argument for a conclusion, you're not intending it to be read as valid. You're acknowledging that the conclusion doesn't follow with certainty from the premises, but you think the inference is strong, that the conclusion is very likely true given the premises. So an argument like this would be described as an inductive argument, since it's obvious that the argument is intended to be strong, not valid. And in this case, the argument is strong. It's a successful inductive argument. But as with deductive arguments, we want to be able to talk about failed inductive arguments, arguments that are intended to be strong but are in fact weak, like this one. Here, we're supposed to infer that simply because Julie has dark hair, she's probably Chinese. This is a weak argument. But we still want to call it an inductive argument if the intention was for it to be strong. In this case, the word most indicates that the inference is intended to be strong rather than valid. So we would call this a weak inductive argument. So the terms inductive and strong have a relationship similar to the terms deductive and valid. To call an argument inductive is to say something about the intentions of the arguer. To call it strong is to say something about the logical properties of the argument itself.